welcome back from the post-tea. So the next speaker is Professor Santosh Mishra from CSIR.
Good afternoon, very distinguished gathering. Back to back, we have had very energetic presentations, and after the tea break, I'm sure we'll be fresh to consider more options. I am from one of the CSIR institutes located on the east coast of India at Bhubaneswar. We work on mineral resources and value-added materials. Part of the CSIR chain of laboratories, one of the large publicly funded R&D organizations of the country, working in diverse areas in almost every field. So in this organization, around middle of the last plan period, 12 to 17, we started taking up a program which we christened as CSIR 800. This 800 denotes the 800 people who are at the bottom of the economic pyramid. And how do we reach them? The focus was to reach the benefits of S&T, science and technology, to these people, to improve the quality of their life and make some kind of economic empowerment. Try to fit them in the value chain so that they improve their current economic standing. The model, all the speakers have said, in this particular situation, S&T intervention will be very situation specific, location specific, and therefore it required a kind of living laboratory where our laboratory people will come into interfacing with the place where we are trying to do the S&T intervention. So what was the basis for this? It was based on some products and some service-based entrepreneurship generation. Multiplier effect, we do something and thereafter the carriers multiply it. We'll have to collaborate with the local universities, institutes and corporate bodies. We will help government reach to a kind of decision where they make it, they push the purchasing from MSME to a certain extent so that the value chain, these industries, these people are fitted into the value chain. Like a government now requires that an MNC setting up shop in India will source 30% locally. So some kind of stipulation should come where some percentage of stipulation of their sourcing in the value chain should come from the MSMEs. We should set up incubation centers, outreach centers with funding support from other ministries or CSIR, corporate societal responsibility funds, or in tie-up with NGOs. There has to be extensive involvement of the corresponding state government and state S&T council, establishment of CSIR state DST center for dissemination. These were the basis on which this program was worked out. What was the motivation for this program? A lot has been said. And the fundamental basis is small is beautiful. We want to find out intermediate technology that will fit somewhere in the value chain. It has to coexist with the centralized high-scale production and pass on the benefit to the rural people. What Schumacher said, the current production technology is increasing rather than reducing the problems of development by deepening dualism between limited urban industrial sector and the vast rural hinterland. To give further motivation, Dr. Swaminathan believed that the township and village enterprises in China that took place in 80s was the framework that managed the transition from agrarian to urban industrialization in China. And he was a fan of that kind of transition process to be tried in India. Now, we focused, our institute focused on 6 areas under this program: water and sanitation, value-added agriculture, agro and food processing, cottage and handicraft, housing and built environment, sustainable energy. For all these areas, CSIR has worked out, CSIR is a chain of laboratories, I said, a number of solutions. Of course, DAE just made a presentation in similar vein, and other institutes like IITs are working. So the idea is to take all these institutes and take it to a location and demonstrate that we can really create value chain from these technologies and shift some of the inclusive manufacturing to these rural areas. For this, we chose one of the most backward regions of the country, the Koraput KBK region of Odisha. The statistics, it is highly dominated with tribal and scheduled caste population, high level of illiteracy, high level of poverty, and in contrary, it is rich in natural resources, rich in forest. It's a beautiful, scenic place, undulated hills, falls, rich in natural resources. So this contrasting scenario of lack of development and rich in natural resources is what exists. So we chose this region to be our living laboratory where we would like to try these technologies. How did we go about? We assigned the PhD students who are doing their doctoral work at our institute to go spend some time and do the resource and need mapping vis-a-vis the technologies that our lab has. They came back, they studied, and they came back with the kind of adaptation that should take place between the technologies that are there in our basket and the local need. We talked to the local member of parliament, Dr. A.B. Swami, who is one of the oldest members of the parliament, late 80s, and he advised that you have to start from where these people are. You cannot supplant or transplant a totally new thing in their ethos, in their culture. Like in IIT Kharagpur, RUTAG is doing, they are taking the production methodology that is there and developing it from there. So that strategy has to be adopted. And in this, we also realized having these smart toilets there will not work out. Having certain devices which worked out in certain zones may not work out there. And that is what we learned. We learned that we have to start from where they are and go forward. We had listed the number of solutions that are available in our basket. I don't want to read there. I will just take a couple of case studies that we did. Here is one water filter which many of you might have seen. This is made from simple pottery clay, sawdust and sand. And it's a wonderful filter, except the only negative point is it removes bacteria to the extent of 90% to 95%. It doesn't make it completely microbiologically safe. And therefore, combined with some other microbiological treatment process, this drinking water filter can be locally made by the potters and can be propagated. And this was a good success. In addition, this is a very good, it's a very good iron removal filter. Our state is sitting in an iron-rich belt where lateritic soil is there. So many places, the water is really iron-laden. So this is a very nice filter for removing iron. In addition, we did improved biomass stoves. Stoves that should not cost so much. For the cost that these people pay, it should last long. If they pay 1,000 rupees, they expect it to last 3 to 5 years. And our stoves had to be appropriately designed, keeping their usage pattern in view and the high temperature corrosion of the parts that take place there. So we developed number of models priced differently, from starting from 700 rupees to community level of 4,000 rupees. These were propagated and they are extremely popular there. Here is a failure thing. You know, we tried to, they have a lot of agro waste. They collect a lot of forest waste, twigs, these, that. With shredding, they can be made powderized. And with powderization, we can make them gasify and run an engine and generate power. But it needs much higher level entrepreneurship, much higher level skill to take it and make it operational. So things, simple things like water filter or chula that is taken to the local level, building materials. But the moment you take it a notch higher, you need some other mechanism to transfer that to these people. We also tried compost, biochar cum mineral mix. We found a lot of rocks out there that contain potash. There are waste rocks in India which contain phosphate below the recommended processing label. So we tried that with compost and biochar and got good results. But these things for long-term propagation need certification from the agricultural universities for long-term evaluation. What kind of impact it will have on soil. There is another interesting, we found there is a district in which has lot of these raw gemstones they are producing. All mafias, you know, they collect, there is no regulated way of doing it. These gemstones, we figured out, if we improve their quality a little bit, they are giving it at throwaway prices. And they are going to distant centers like Jaipur or Bombay. I'm finishing. So we thought of producing a mobile unit where we will take a laser processing thing, a heating furnace, and things like that, that can improve its value. Now we have submitted it to the state government, and we are finding out a legal way of setting up the gem processing center. Of course, one of our laboratories and sister laboratories in Mysore, they came forward, they submitted a list of products, agro products, which they can process. We displayed them, we conducted road shows, and now three ways are there to take it forward. The one which we have done direct one-to-one. The other one is set up incubators, set up technology incubators with large-scale money input where the farmers, cooperatives, they can bring their products. The incubators will charge a conversion fee and they will take it back, or the incubators can market it themselves. Or we can induce companies, big companies, to come and encourage home-based manufacturing. They will give the implements, they will give the specifications, and encourage home-based manufacturing. These are the next two steps. We have submitted a proposal under the Atal Incubation Mission ourselves in partnership with a private body. So this is what I said, this is the way forward, that we are on the next two steps. Based on our persuasion and to the government letters and all, a food park is now being set up, maybe by ITC, maybe by some other company who will try to source from this area. So now the key takeaways. We need outreach centers for R&D organizations like us, like Department of Atomic Energy has done. This is existing for ICAR, and that's why ICAR is able to push the agriculture related technology. We also need support, government support for funding of incubators in these districts. And this is the last sentence. And the labs themselves have to take the risk of validating the technology. They cannot offload it to the incubator. Thank you.